More than a million calls to the federal government's poison helpline every year involve children 5 and under. It is a number that health experts are trying to bring down as part of Poison Prevention Week. Well, joining me now to talk about maybe some of the hidden hazards in your home is Dr. Shannon Cohen from Children's Hospital. Good to see you.
Nice.
Thank you for being with us.
Thank you.
Let's talk about some of the children you have treated for accidental poisoning.
One of the common things we're actually seeing in the emergency room right now are those little laundry pods. They're bright, they're colorful. Children will look at them and want to eat them because they think they're candy or a toy. And those are actually quite dangerous. They can cause airway damage, eye damage, damage to the esophagus or, you know, the feeding tube that you eat through.
Oh, just a painful, terrible thing to have happen. Let's go through this then. That's the laundry room. Let's go through this room by room. Common poisonous things we can find. Let's start in the kitchen.
Okay. So things that you have in the kitchen are medications, household cleaners, those things. Moving on to the bedroom, you could have things on the nightstand, such as eye drops that you don't even think about.
Those can make a child really sick, and I did not realize that until not that long ago.
Mm-hmm. Yes, they
can. Just a few drops.
Just a few drops is all it takes.
Now, what does that do?
It just depends on the type of eye drop that you have.
Okay.
This is the different effects that it can have.
Goodness
a lot
gracious.
Of different things.
And a bathroom.
Bathroom. You can have makeup, actually, some people don't think about. Mm-hmm. Can have some chemicals in it that can be toxic. Mouthwash.
All kinds of stuff that we as parents of young children really need to think about and put up. So, you know, let's go back to the kitchen because it's so easy to store our items under the cabinet. We still can if we do the proper locking, right?
Right. I mean, what we recommend is that items that children could get into that could be potentially toxic be stored out of sight and out of reach. So higher and where they in a cabinet that it cannot be seen. But if it needs to be in a lower cabinet, then we recommend safety locks on the cabinet.
All right. Very good. Now, let's go back to the kids and some of the signs and symptoms that something is wrong.
So all of a sudden drooling, vomiting, and if they all of a sudden have a sudden change in their behavior or if they look confused, those kinds of things.
Listless, that kind of thing where you know that
something's just not right.
And it's really important to keep the poison helpline number saved in your phone.
Right. So when you do have an accidental poisoning, you're going to be, you know, frantic and concerned about what to do, and you may not be able to think of that number right off. So it's really good to program it into your phone or have it near a phone, like if you have a babysitter there.
Okay, and we have the number there on your screen. We'll remind you, 1-800-222-1222.
That's
easy
correct.
To remember, but again, in a crisis situation, it's good to have it right there that you can call up. All right, doctor, thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you.
Great advice. And if you have a question about your child's health, just email me at ltucker@wate.com. And be sure to tune in every Thursday here on WATE 6 on Your Side News at 5:30 to see if we use your question on the air.